Over here in the upper right, we have the player that Tastosis has nicknamed the Kratos Protoss.
Odious MC.
You haven't played God of War 3 yet, have you?
God of War 3, no.
I will actually lend you my PlayStation. Oh, no, you have a PlayStation 3. You gotta, you actually got to do that. Quite a good game. Now, over here, in the bottom left, loser of the first set here. Can he come back? He is...
Hoang Prime V.
Well, Tasteless, you know, he did just such a risky, risky build there. And it seems like some of these Protosses that are very high level... Oh, look at that.
What is that?
It's a picture of a carrier.
All right. Thought it was the ugliest foot in the world. Sorry, go ahead.
That would be a pretty ugly foot. But this kind of reminds me of the way that we recently saw some Protosses try to play against Soki Su. You know, Trickster, Tester.
Yeah, actually.
Where they're like, okay, I kind of know that you are better than me. And, you know, instead of just trying to play a straight-up game against you with a safe build, one of the 2 to 3 safe builds in PvP, I'm going to go ahead and just take a huge risk. And these very top Protosses are just learning, hey, if I just go 4 warp gate, these guys that are trying to take risks against me are dead.
Yeah.
Because the risky builds are very good against anything but 4 warp gate. But when you go 4 warp gate, man.
You know, I'm not shocked coming from Hung, and he's the kind of guy who would try to finesse his way to a win rather than being like, all right, I'm going to go with the orthodox openers.
Yeah.
I'm curious to see what he's going to do this game, because this is another map where 4 warp gate rushing is very, very good. In fact, I still 4 warp gate rush on this map. Despite all the other builds out there, because it is so easy to get warp in units, put a pile on the low ground, and warp stuff in onto the high ground.
So far, exactly the same builds. MC has used one more Chrono Boost than Hongan has, which is actually very interesting and very telling. That's one thing you definitely want to watch in PvP, is how many Chrono Boosts your opponent's Nexus has. Because if you use more than 2 on probes, then that oftentimes means something very important, Tasteless. Second gas, very quick for MC.
Now, Hongan is Chrono Boosting out a Stalker, and that's not actually ordinary for the Warp Gate Rush build, so I don't think we're going to see that from him. And his second gas will confirm my suspicion now. OGSMC did get a second gas after chasing out the Scouting Probe, so OGSMC... going to go ahead and wane away from a 4 warp gate rush, change the pacing. He's already shown Hongan how intimidating his rushes can be. This time around, Hongan would probably be more prepared, so he might as well go for a different opener.
And Hongan, again, seeing the second gas, gets a super fast robo.
Oh,
MC adding gates. In fact, what MC might be doing here, possibly, look at this, another micro battle in the middle, a very important micro battle.
And if MC does this right, he is going to win this.
I actually can't believe that Hongan is...
Hongan is actually...
I don't know what to call
apart.
It, man. It's like he's dead to the world. When you let your Stalker take a hit from a Zealot in a battle like that, you get so far behind.
Well, the Stalker's never actually supposed to be touched.
Yeah, except by the other Stalker.
Yeah.
And we see MC going for what looks like a Blink Rush.
Oh, this is a good build.
Yeah, I know. Blink is normally what you see from a super fast second gas. But sometimes you do see these other builds, like the Robo that we see from Hongan. Now, Hongan's build is actually going to be pretty strong against the Blink Rush if he plays very Turtle style.
Oh, and in case you guys are wondering why we know it's Blink and not DT, Hongan did reveal that he was getting a Robo Bay. So there's no logical reason for why you'd go DT if you know he's going to have detection.
Plus 3 warp gates. I mean, that's actually the number of warp gates you get when you're going Blink Stalkers.
Exactly. 2 is normally for DTs, and then you try to expand.
Yeah. Now, so Hongan, he should have enough to hold this. What he's going to want to do is when he realizes his Blink, get out a second Immortal as quickly as possible and just warp in some Zealots. Probably have 2-3 Stalkers in there, but it's very important to have a lot of Immortals. Notice he is making another Immortal. And what you're going to want to do is put Zealots not only in the front of your ramp, but also behind your Immortals, so that when they blink up on you, your Zealots have surface area all over the place, because they have higher DPS, and they basically beat Stalkers heads up. So if your opponent's trying to actually blink up there, it's not going to work out very well.
Now, Hongan is going for Colossus here. We saw him get the robotic support bay. And one thing about going Blink is that even though Stalkers aren't necessarily good against Colossuses, Colossi, if I'm Artosis saying it, you can Blink on top of the Colossus and, you know, focus fire it. And also, this will nullify.
Here we go.
That's going to nullify.
And targeting down as quickly as he can on all these immortals. And will Hongun be able to hold off some interesting force fields?
Actually, not entirely sure those are the best force fields he could have used.
Yeah, they were interesting. And MC in a little bit of trouble, Tasteless. See, that's the thing. When you have a couple mortals out with some Zealots, you're just dealing more damage to the Stalkers than they're dealing to you. But Hongun, he's a little bit behind on units still.
He needs to wait for his blink to cool down and blink away the Stalkers that are being hit like he just did there.
But out comes the Immortal, and he has to get out of there.
Oh, nice.
Bam.
Denial.
Beautiful use of that
sentry. Sick, man. Yep. Damn, dude.
Now, here's the thing. Again, if you play Turtle Style against this type of blink, you can completely crush it with Robotic Splay. The Immortals just are worth their weight in gold against these Stalkers. The Zealots do well when you blink on top. And what he's going to want to do from here, Tasteless, is get out Colossi.
Yep.
And then see if he can chase the Stalkers home. Now, the thing is that this is a big map. This is a long map. If you try to actually just move out with your Colossi and attack move across the map, he can go ahead and counterattack you.
He's actually going for a light contain here. But that only lasts for so long because Colossus could just step on a force field and it goes away. Yet a Terran cannot land a command center on a force field.
That's right. Totally awesome so far, Tasteless. I'm having such a great time watching this game.
And I love what he's doing here. This peeking with the Stalkers. He just says, okay, is there another Immortal coming out?
You know, normally that works very well, but with two Immortals there, you notice that Stalker took some damage. Normally you try to just blink them away before they go past the shields.
What the reason why Immortals are so good against Stalkers with blink too is that when Stalkers fire, there's an animation that has to connect to the unit. Hold that thought. And that's why Force Field is not good against this.
And here we go. Mitchell is going to have to run away. But here is the risky part. If Hongun just goes up the ramp, those blink Stalkers come back and they go and wreak havoc on
this
his main.
This is smart.
When Hongun turns around, the blink Stalkers go away. So Hongun actually looks like he's going to be able to take this game down, Tasteless. This is a huge move.
MC is counterattacking now, and it looks like Hongun bit the bait.
Yeah, I can't believe Hongun actually.
Oh my god, he's going to get that. Oh! He gets it.
And now all he has to do is blink away.
I was going to say, go home now. Blink.
And bam, he gets out of there, kills some units, and suddenly Hongun is pretty much dead. I mean, this is how you do the blink Stalker, Tasteless. When they leave, you go into their main base.
Uh-oh. He's got to be careful.
Yep. He's just got to not engage ever. He's got the mobility.
Now, it looks like due to the angle at which he was chased out, he is going to get back to his opponent's base first. Hongun Prime will have a counterattack opportunity to MC. Those Immortals are going to be quite strong. I was cut off briefly because the Colossus came out. But the Immortal fire animation, it doesn't have an animation that actually has to connect to the unit portrait, so it'll always do the damage. Unlike the Stalker thing, if the shot doesn't hit the unit, you can blink through it. All right, now it looks like there's going to be somewhat of a base trade here.
Yes, there
However,
Oh, nice. Very good move there. Does not want those probes on the map. They actually could end up making a difference. Now, here's the thing. How much money does MC actually have worked up? And it looks like he has enough to make a whole nother round of Zealots. And that leaves him with 15 Stalkers and 4 Zealots. That's going to be against 3 Zealots and a Immortal, 13 Stalkers, and a Sentry. But here is the kicker, Tasteless. MC, even though he has fewer units overall than Hongun, he has Blink. So when this comes down to just a micro battle, he's going to be able to take it. But can they actually leave each other's buildings?
Do they have enough hidden structures? Okay, they are both throwing structures up everywhere. Both nexuses have been destroyed. About 2 hidden pylons here from Hongun 1 in the center of the map. That's really a sign of desperation. He had to throw that up somewhere. The other right outside of the main. Now remember, if you can actually circumvent your opponent's army and not engage them. Okay, actually, I'm going to call this right now. I was going to say, I don't think I actually can get rid of these structures in time.
Oh, my.
Okay, that's it. Yeah. MC
is going to be able to win this actually quite easily from here. I'm surprised that Hongun is up with his entire army in the main base, not defending any of his structures.
That's it. I think he's gone, right? It's been eliminated.
That's all his
My God.
Oh, wow.
Oh, whoa.
Absolutely.
Oh, now this is so going to be very weird because I can't believe he's actually going to go down the ramp. I was going to say it's going to be very weird because he can hold that position. We could have a draw.
Yeah, what he should do is go for the draw, Tasteless.
Yeah, he should not be going down the ramp.
With Blink, these Stalkers should be able to out-micro his opponent. Those Zealots taking a lot of good hits. And suddenly, look at that. Just blinking away. And what he's going to want to do is wait for shields to recharge, go in, get a hit, blink away. Might go on the high ground here. And look at that, just blinking. Beautiful for you, Blink Micro by MC. But this Immortal doing insanity damage.
Actually,
and MC, I can't believe he's actually doing this.
MC doesn't have proper surface area
here. Well, he shouldn't be battling heads up. Hongun actually had
a
superior
armor. My God! It's actually going to go to a base. Oh my God. It's going to be whoever can eliminate this pylon quicker.
Insane.
It's whoever can eliminate this structure quicker. Oh!
So close!
All right, get ready. He's moving down.
And it looks like MC is going to be able to do it.
Is he going to do it? Oh! Oh my God, that's so cool.
Wow.
Wow. Well, this is going down in esports history.
That was very, 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 very close. Now, MC did make a couple small mistakes because with Blink, he should be able to win those battles pretty easily.
Yeah.
You know, what you do is you just go up, snipe, deal some real damage, and blink away. And you just wear down your opponent's army with the Blink. So actually engaging there was definitely a mistake. But then because he had Blink, he got to his opponent's pylon before his opponent got to his. That's actually what won it, Tasteless.
Yeah.
That would have been down to the millisecond otherwise.
You know what's so funny about it is that we were saying, well, he's going to win this because he can blink and win the battle.
Yeah.
And then he was mis-microing. There were like two lions like this, and there were Stalkers that were stuck in the back. And, at first I thought, oh, my God, he's going to lose this. He's just going to lose all his use. Then he went around, and because he had Blink and he could just skip there a little bit quicker, he managed to take out Hongun's pylon before Hunger could take out his. That game was incredible.
That was a great game.
That was an insane game.
Showed you guys a lot about the way to use Blink Stalker.
Yeah.
When you're playing against Blink Stalker, you can't just walk across the map, Tasteless. Again, just to reiterate what Hongun should have done once he had his Colossus, I would not even move out with one. That's scary. What you need to do is turtle, see if you can chase him back to their main base. If you can't, that's fine. Expand. You're fine.
Also, note, Hongun could have actually held his ramp and possibly forced a draw or at least pressured MC into trying to attack up it.
Also, when Hongun made the closer pylon, he ended up with 350 minerals. He could have just stayed up the ramp, built another Nexus if he had just counted his money a little bit carefully.
Yeah.
So, such an interesting game. But, of course, in weird endgame situations like that, everyone makes a ton of wrong moves.
Well, all of a sudden, it's so many very important decisions. And the control has got to be so precise. All right, guys, go on Twitter.
Hashtag the
GSL.
If you don't have a Twitter,
don't be one of those people like, I already had a Facebook, I don't want to get Twitter. Do it. Plug GSL. We'll be back in about 5 minutes.